already underway, and this place is rocking with some great performances. For more on that, to Terry Gannon and Sam Pesher. Terry.
Mike, thank you. Should be a great night. Everything on the line. Take you back to this opening rotation, which is now complete, and Simone Biles opened up on vault, Sam.
It's the most difficult vault in the entire world. Two flips in the air before she hits the ground, although we've seen her do better.
She got there and then some. And Suni Lee, who's from St. Paul, right across the river. Basically, the individual apparatus, the way she got there, which doesn't exist anymore. But they are favored to go back again. There's another spot open, five spots in all. Jordan Chiles, who has been terrific. Here she is on uneven bars.
And this is a key event for her in a three-up, three-count Team USA situation. She most likely would compete here. Has to practice when she breathes because it's such a long bar routine.
Oh, yeah. The 23-year-old from Vancouver, Washington, who trains in Spring, Texas.
Let's go!
Parents, Gina and Timothy, Cecile Landy, one of her coaches, and a star at UCLA, now back on the elite level in a position to head back.
Her posture is just so beautiful on this event. Artistry is something that judges look for, and she does that really well.
And knows that one. You know, 13 athletes competing tonight, but we had three more that many expected to be right there to make the team. And unfortunately, injuries set in. Sky Blakely, take you back to Wednesday podium training on floor and the Achilles.
It was really tough to watch. We knew something serious had happened right when she landed, had to be carried off the floor.
So an Achilles injury for her, and then competition, Kayla DiCello on vault.
This is an athlete that most likely would not be put in on a three-up, three-count situation for Team USA, but she can hit this bar routine no matter what. The goal for her is to be calm and confident. Not quite the difficulty that some of the other girls in the competition have.
This time around, I think Simone's expected to be there too. Coming up in a little bit on Uneven Bars. The thrill of the summer is here, and your favorite ninjas are taking the competition to new heights. Don't miss American Ninja Warrior tomorrow, NBC Peacock. The men's team was named yesterday. They're watching the action tonight as we send it over to the three-time Olympian, John Roethlisberger. John, sort this out, the team selection tonight.
Yeah, Terry, you talk about all the injuries to the U.S. women's team. It has been a house of horrors for them, honestly. Three athletes arguably in the top five in this country. Two of them are former world all-around medalists. The one thing we know for sure about this team is it will be a different team than we thought it was going to be a couple of days ago. So here's how it looks right now in our opinion. That top line, those are all alumni of the Olympic Games. They're all in Tokyo. Simone, Suni, Jordan, Jade. Right now, we think they're in. That leaves one spot for the rest of the field to vie for. Who do we think are the front runners for that spot? Hesley, Jocelyn, Tiana, and Leanne. They've all started hot tonight here in day two, and it's going to come down to how do they fit with those top four gymnasts on that top line to make the strongest team. It is going to be really tight for that one spot. So how does this affect Team USA going into the Olympics? Well, here's what they've done since 2016. They've won all golds. The only hiccup, if you will, was Tokyo, where they won silver. But if we look at the scores of the team right now, losing those three athletes, it's about a two-point drop in that team score. Should they win? Absolutely. Do I think they'll still go and get that gold? Most likely, but it just got a whole lot more interesting.
Alicia Sacramone Quinn heading up that selection committee, and it is not tied to math like the men's. If you watched yesterday, the all-around winner here is automatically selected. Right now, that's Simone Biles leading the way, and then it is up to the selection committee. Here is Simone on Uneven Bars.
Far away from the bar on that catch. She looks a little off balance, bringing back the rhythm here to make some solid connections from high to low. She's so fast on this event. She had to work for that bar routine tonight, but she got the job done.
Mom loves it. I'm sorry. I know we see it, and she makes it look like, oh, I just do this all the time, but it's amazing when you watch that.
It really is, and you can see she's happy to get through that one. Hey, you can't be perfect all the time, Terry.
No, but just the dismount. I mean, it's as high as she is in the air. We're going to see on floor later on as well. Spectacular. Here near her hometown. And the reception, once again, a great opening on Uneven Bars, now on beam for Suni Lee.
She has the most amount of difficulty on beam in this competition, sitting in first place after night one.
Oh, hello.
It's really tough to have a fall on beam, especially on your first element, because you still gotta finish the routine. It's a broken connection, so unfortunately her start value and difficulty score won't be as high tonight. She looks really off tonight.
Sam, how much would that hurt her?
You know, I'm thinking about it because this is a really big event that Team USA needs their veterans to hit on. I don't think it'll affect her chances to make this team, but it's hard to simulate this environment in practice, so they need to be able to hit under pressure here.
Does it make the other beam routines for the younger gymnasts even that much more important?
It does. Yeah, they really need athletes to step up on this event.
That's true, Sam, but I do agree with your first statement. I think this is not going to keep her off the team. That bar routine is so valuable, and I know they're really focusing on trials. Well, the first day of trials, she won this event. If you go back to championships, she hit 2 days in a row there, and they know that woman right there, Alicia Sacramone Quinn, knows that she can perform under pressure. So, again, not a good thing, but I don't think it's going to keep her off the team.
So right from the start, problems.
She does a layout onto the beam, and you can see her arm positions just were not mirrored in the center of the beam. You can see from overhead, it's only 4 inches wide. Her feet actually look straight on the beam, but her arms are a little bit crazy. I view arms on balance beam like the steering wheel. So if both of them are to the left, your body will be to the left. You really need to keep your arms even on the beam. Didn't push fully out of that last leg into the layout. Look at her toes. You can see right there that toes position were off the beam completely, making it really tough to minimize those wobbles.
Terry, I don't know about you, but that view from above the beam, it makes me break out into cold sweat. Sam, it might be a comfortable place for her, but that is just a daunting view of this event.
Oh, how narrow that beam is?
Yeah.
I know. And what they do on the beam, incredible. So you look up, upper left, you got the top three. We'll keep you up to date with those, including the score on bars, 14.2 for Simone.
Coupleton's lower than night one, but again, should not affect her chances in the slightest.
Thinking about Suni Lee, the journey too. I mean, so much uncertainty along the way, getting everything right, taking it step by step just to be at this point. Like championships opening up with a struggle. Simone going back to help her out. She's telling her, I've been there. I know what you're going through, getting her back out. It's just seeing her here compete is special. The problems on the beam a moment ago as we check in with Zora Stevenson.
Yeah, Terry, let's talk about one of the youngest competitors here at Trials, Hesley Rivera. Her family actually made the decision to move from New Jersey to Texas a little while ago in support of her gymnastics. So not only a new state, a new coach, but a new schedule as well. And we are going to detail it for you. And it mirrors so many of the gymnasts here today. Hesley told us she's in the gym every day around 8 a.m. After 3 hours of training, a teacher helps homeschool all of the gymnasts. That's from 11:30 to 3. Then there's another 3 hours of practice. From there, they go 3 to 6 once they get back into the gym. So there's a lot that goes into getting to this point. And when I asked Hesley's dad about the grueling schedule, he said, she is the hardest working human I have ever met.
Yeah, it's not 9 to 5. It's beyond that. And here she is on beam, a critical routine now.
This is an event that is so important for her. She has one of the highest difficulties in this competition. And if she can knock it out of the park, she might be on this Olympic team. You can see how sharp she's getting to those landing positions. That's a good thing. She's working really well. Needing to remember to breathe. It's funny as a gymnast that you have to remind yourself to breathe in these key moments. Even though it's a minute and a half, you still gotta breathe.
Just turned 16 years of age, heading to the 11th grade from Oradell, New Jersey. Hesley Rivera, Dad Henry, Mom Heidi there. Yeah, that was him.
He knows that's going to be a big number. This is huge for Hesley.
She said, I'm just getting used to this level. I just need to trust myself more. That number lower than she wanted, obviously. 12.825 on beam for Suni Lee. So you want to be in the green. That's excellent. Solid as yellow. Trying to listen in. Maybe through the night. So onward here. The final night. Olympic trials for the women.
My daughter works hard. And so do people with type 2 diabetes. But if their efforts aren't enough, could people do diabetes differently?
They can with once-weekly Mounjaro. 3 out of 4 people reached an A1C of less than 7%. Plus, people taking Mounjaro lost up to 25 pounds. Mounjaro is not for people with type 1 diabetes or children. Don't take Mounjaro if you're allergic to it, you or your family have medullary thyroid cancer, or multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2. Stop Mounjaro and call your doctor right away if you have an allergic reaction, a lump or swelling in your neck, severe stomach pain, vision changes, or diabetic retinopathy. Serious side effects may include pancreatitis and gallbladder problems.
Terry Gannon back with Sam Peschek, part of that Olympic silver medal team back in 2008 for the U.S. John Roethlisberger, a 3-time Olympian. How about the number for Hesley Rivera, the teenager trying to make the team?
Yeah, that's what she needed to do. This score would have put her second behind Sue.
Very much, again, in the mix for at least that one spot. 5 spots in all available. Gianna Sumina-Sekera a moment ago on uneven bars. Second season on the senior elite level from Pleasanton, California, the 16-year-old.
This is not a critical event for Tiana in order to make this team, but it is good news if she hits it. Let's say that.
I don't think so.
Okay.
I thought it was a good idea.
Back in Minneapolis, two rotations left. Simone Biles in the lead in this competition and back on the Olympic stage after withdrawing from most of her events at the Tokyo Games. Earlier this year, she spoke with the world's number one female podcaster, Alex Cooper, about that experience in Tokyo. Trials thus gets the automatic berth in the five on the U.S. Olympic team. Also great perspective in visiting with Alex Cooper, who has such popularity, part of the daddy gang, if you will, and Alex will be with us during our coverage of the Olympics. You'll hear a lot more of that very honest, revealing, and insightful conversation. And Terry and Sam, that is part of what has brought Simone back to this stage with the great success she's having.
Mike, different outlook this time around, but I think, Sam, because she was so open talking about the mental side of these days, going from the elite level, even the Olympics, back to compete in college, and back to the elite level again. She's in pre-med at the University of Florida, had a 4.0 GPA in the spring.
Okay.
And a four-time world medalist as well. We'll get the number in a moment, but over to balance beam, always critical. One of the needs for the team at the Olympics, Jade Carey getting set.
This looks really calm and solid.
You too.
Including that goal on floor exercise at the Olympics.
I think that really increases her chances of being on this Olympic team. If she wasn't a lock for the selection committee already, I think that helps her out.
How about the number on floor for Leanne Wong, 13.625.
Her first three passes were solid.
It's apparent what she can do on floor exercise. She was playing catch-up when she got here because of an ankle injury that took her out of most of the U.S. championships. And, yes, it is all about tonight now, but they do consider your past performances. 13.625 on beam for Jade Carey.
Exactly what we can expect from Jade, consistency.
All right, Simone Biles in first overall, ready to go on balance beam. Did not have the best night one.
Man, how strange.
That was so good.
Did she say that was so good up until that point?
That's exactly what I was thinking too, Terry. I was like, she can't do this better. I'm glad I didn't say it out loud, because that's what happened right after that. Had that thought go through my head.
Well, it was a determined Simone Biles at the start of that routine, and early on had the trouble on night one. Not this time. It was later on.
This new floor routine music is by Lindsey Stirling's new album coming out. Same artist she used for her music in 2021, so it's special for her.
And if we see Suni Lee and Simone Biles as expected on that team, it'll be the first time that any country has sent a team with two all-around Olympic gold medalists.
in these pressure moments. And we're seeing that glimmer of greatness that we know Sunni is just can beat so well.
Okay, so Sunni is one of the four Olympians last time around that most expect to be part of this team. We don't know that, just assuming that right now. We'll see. But how about the young stars? Who stands out? Maybe a Hesley Rivera at this point?
Yeah, Hesley is doing everything in her power to increase her chances of being on this team. And she looks like an athlete that's unfazed. She just puts her scenario and would be competing on beam. So this is a huge moment for her.
And just to put it in perspective, Hesley got a 14.275 on this event earlier tonight. I feel like Tiana wants to give herself a chance. She absolutely has to go higher than that.
That start always gets me.
Needs to be aggressive and sharp. You can see that she's adjusting in the air on those skills to eliminate any wobbles. That's really the mark of a great beam worker. Not really that you're straight on all your skills, but that you can adjust quickly. Extra power on that last pass, but night one, she had a 3/10 out of bounds deduction, so we can expect this to at least be 3/10 higher.
I can say this.
If she nails this beam routine, the selection committee is going to have a hard time.
She heard you.
What's impressive to me about these younger athletes is the arena is full. There's a lot of pressure, and they are bringing the heat.
The target center hanging on every moment. Watch this.
Okay. Didn't go out. Woo!
Yeah! Yeah! Henry's the louder of the two. He's been cheering all night long.
Mom is nervous chewing.
Down to the last apparatus for any of those four. What kind of pressure will some young women be facing in this sold-out arena with Simone and all the experienced athletes around there trying to be their teammate?
I mean, my heart is just beating for everyone here. However, I will say, we do have two 16-year-olds, some fresh faces, some underdogs, and it seems like they're doing just fine under this pressure.
Well, that is something you know about, because when you were part of the Final Five, winning a gold medal with the team and a silver. Yeah. All right, Lori, see you there. Back to you, Terry.
All right, Mike, thank you. So Jordan Chiles getting set on beam. Just go back to that number for a moment. The score for Jocelyn Robertson, that's critical. It's going to make it tough.
Yeah, it now puts her tied with Hesley in that first place on balance beam. That's huge.
Chiles on beam.
Quickly as possible.
And she is not happy. Parents keeping her in it. Cecile Landy, Laurent Landy, UCLA, but didn't have a great elite season last year and missed the world championship team. But the buildup now with the competitions up until these trials has been very good for Jordan Childs, getting better and better. Remember how good she was in the trials back in 2021. Didn't miss a routine and has that experience. Toughest for the parents in the stands. I know it's exciting, but it's excruciating too.
There we go! Yeah!
This Wednesday,
we are here.
The 2024 U.S. Olympic Trials are brought to you by Despicable Me 4 in theaters Wednesday. 12-2-2-5 for Jordan Childs on Beam just a moment ago as the action continues here in Minneapolis inside the Target Center. Terry Gannon back with Sam Peschek. We talked about that fifth and final spot. You said maybe Hesley Rivera had the edge. Jocelyn Robertson not making it easy for those on the selection committee, but we still have Simone Biles on floor.
Yeah, Hesley and Jocelyn are separated by a 1/10 in the all-arounds. They're making it interesting, but we still have Simone Biles to finish this up.
Which is always amazing to watch her, and you just shake your head the whole time, say, how does she do what she does on floor exercise?
Well, it's because she does the hardest tumbling pass in the world. This is a triple-double. Incredibly difficult. She uses a lot of power and momentum to get this night one. I wonder how high she's going to get here tonight in the building.
Yeah, amazing stuff. Time and again on floor exercise. And Taylor Swift, Beyonce, part of the music for this. And so the tweet, ready for it? And Taylor Swift with the response, watched this so many times and still unready. She's ready for it, though. Pretty cool.
Yeah, I wonder if she's ready for night two. I know I am.
Taylor's kind of busy right now, too, but getting a chance to watch the action as
well. Maybe we'll see her in
tour.
Paris, Terry.
I know, exactly. So the standings after seven rotations, Simone Biles with that lead. Remember, the top all-arounder locks up a spot. Here she is on floor exercise.
Incredible.
Simone Biles makes impossible an opinion. I've said it before, and there's no truer statement. Never thought I would see someone do gymnastics the way she does.
How many people really thought she'd be back on the road to Paris at this point, where she is right now?
I think that's a good question. I knew in my heart she was going to be back.
Why?
She has that look in her eye. She's a fierce athlete.
Never disappoints. Still taking it all in here on night two of the Olympic trials. No doubt on her way to the all-around title.
This is huge for Hesley. If she can knock it out of the park, she might be on this Olympic team.
There'll be deliberation, elation, and emotion coming up.
So we close it out, the final rotation here, the final night of the Olympic trials in Minneapolis. 14-7-2-5, the number for Simone Biles on floor exercise. All right, here's the final event for Tiana Soumanosakura, right in the mix for a spot.
Olympic year was the first time and the right time to choreograph a routine to it. She's been choreographing her routine since compulsory. She said it has a majestic princess vibe, and it's fitting because her coach, Laurent Landy, calls her Princess Tiana.
Doing everything she can to make that team. Sam, this is a pretty impressive night.
She really couldn't have done anything better in the last two.
Make that team, Hesley Rivera from New Jersey.
Big improvement from night one. She was only 1/10 behind Jocelyn in the all-around standings coming into this last event. This is going to help her out.
Mom's like, okay, settle down now. This just making it really difficult on the selection committee.
They knew that they were athletes on the bubble coming into this, and they're really bringing the heat start to finish on all four events.
13-7-2-5, Sumana Sacra on floor. And now Jocelyn Robertson on floor exercise.
Is the third highest start value on this event. Huge tumbling passes right here. Double twisting, double layout to a stuck position. Veteran move right there in the corner.
This is buzzing. Come on.
The audience is erupting. Everyone's on their feet. What is the selection committee going to do?
Might as well take the seats out. No one's sitting in them anymore. They are on their feet the entire time.
One incredible night at the Olympic trials. And yes, we expect it from those we saw in Tokyo, but you know, the men's team, they're standing and cheering as well. For all the young gymnasts to get closer, they're doing everything. Hesley Rivera, has she done enough? Listen
to
me. He thinks so. We're not sure. We gotta wait for that team to be named. Wow. All around. The score for Jocelyn Robertson on floor exercise, 13-9-2-5. I mean, everybody has been impressive. How about the number on vault for Hesley Rivera, 14.2?
That was a big improvement and really helped her all-around standing score.
But Simone Biles cannot be caught. She will be heading back to the Olympics, the winner of the all-around here. Take you back to the World Championships in 2023. She wrapped up her sixth world all-around title. She was the first woman to win five and now just extends that record. Rebeca Andrade from Brazil on the left will be her biggest competition at the Olympics, but Simone will be favored, obviously, to win the all-around. Jade Carey hoping, expecting to be there with her as a part of the team competition this time. Still more to come from the Target Center. Do as if we have to. The Olympic Games return less than a month. Live from Paris on NBC and Peacock. The Olympic trials taking place, Minneapolis as well. Boy, what a beautiful setting there. The opening ceremony right along the Seine. All right, if you're not having any fun yet, I mean, I don't know how, but you're about to. Jordan Chiles already dancing, getting set over on floor.
It's such a fan favorite routine, and you're going to see why. She gets the crowd involved. She makes everyone smile, and you got to be dancing in your seat.
Tears, smiles, tears. And does anybody have more fun on floor exercise than Jordan Chiles? I know the family had fun. Jordan Chiles is that girl, the shirts say.
It's her new motto, and she actually uses that phrase as a daily reminder of who she is and what she's capable of, and it's been working for her this weekend. What a performance.
You know, the build in this entire arena, the noise from start to finish of that routine, and now Leanne Wong finishing up over on vault.
She is such a gamer. This is really important. That looks really good. There was some discrepancy night one on whether she had repulsion off of both of her hands. Struggled in warm-up a bit, but was able to put this one to her feet.
All right. How about the score for Childs? 14-1 on floor exercise in the green. You saw that satisfaction, the tears on her face as she finished up that routine. And then the high five from her training partner and friend, Simone Biles. Back inside the Target Center, 14-5 for Leanne Wong on vault.
It was much better than night one. Certainly got that second hand pushing, and it would look great to me.
All right. Over to wrap things up, floor exercise. And how about we do that with the reigning Olympic gold medalist on floor, Jade Carey.
The second highest difficulty score next to Simone Biles, in a large part because of this pass.
This routine for Jade Carey, potentially a ticket to Paris. This is where she shines, this in the vault.
One step out of bounds. She had that night one as well. Not a make or break though. Double. This routine is jam-packed with difficulty.
Jade Carey showing you why she won gold in Tokyo. So that team selection committee leaving to go backstage, and they'll start to do their work. You've got to pick five team members, four of them still in play, because Simone Biles has won the all-around. That's an automatic selection. We know she's going to Paris. We do not know for sure who's going to join her.
Man, I'm shaking my head because I would not want to be one of them right now. These athletes made it so hard for them to have a clear-cut answer for the five athletes on this team. There's so much to factor in. Results from this weekend, consistency.
They got the gymnastics down, but they had to work on the chant a little bit, I think.
Well, it's clear what they've been spending their time on, and it's not chance.
I got to give a shout out to Brian Carey, Jay Carey's dad. He had a plan this whole year, and it culminated with that floor team. Built every meet better and better, and it got to that moment, and it could be enough for her.
So you see those top four: Simone Biles, Suni Lee, Jordan Childs, Jade Carey. They were all at the Tokyo Olympics. Don't yet know whether they will all four be on this team, but it looked good coming into the night, and they finish the top four. Take it all in, Jordan Childs. You deserve it. All right, so now the work begins for the selection committee, and we'll eventually get the names. We do know that Simone Biles has won the all-around. Standing by with Zora.
Simone, another one. So much has happened since Tokyo, but what led you back to this point, back to another Olympics?
Yeah, being in a good mental spot, seeing my therapist every Thursday, it's kind of religious for me, so that's why I'm here today.
It's hard not to come back to when you have all these people cheering you on. I can't believe I'm about to say this, but at 27 years old, you are the oldest female American gymnast since the 1950s to head to the Olympics. How did you know that you had more to give this sport?
Yeah, I knew I wasn't done after the performances in Tokyo, so just getting back in the gym and working hard and trusting the process with Cecile and Laurent, I knew I'd be back.
I watched you this entire weekend, and you were cheering everybody on. You were instructing Jade. No matter who makes this team, why is it important for you to be a mentor and a leader?
Because I've been in their exact same spot, so I know exactly how they're feeling. And if I can be a mentor and a guide, then that's what I'm going to do to kind of lighten the load.
My job here, Simone, is to get answers for the people. After your floor routine on night one, Taylor Swift commented and said she wasn't ready, but you're ready. Did she know that you were going to use her music? Did you all chat about that?
I think my team talks to her team sometimes, and I've met her a couple times, so it's been really sweet.
Simone Biles, everyone, congrats.
Thank you.
Congrats indeed. Going back to her third Olympics, just the fourth American woman to accomplish that. Mom and Dad, who keep score throughout, just like in baseball back in the day, you'd be at home watching on TV. They keep score the whole time. Everybody scores. Keep a running tally. So, smiles right now. They've taken all the crowd applause in. We'll see the makeup of the team. We do know that Simone Biles is heading back to the Olympics in Paris. How about Suni Lee, Robinson, the rest, Jordan Chiles too. We'll find out in a bit here by the end of the broadcast in Minneapolis.
I will ask you guys to take a seat here, and I'm just going to ask you a couple of questions.
Okay.
And you can just look right into this lens. I'm ask you just a couple things about your wonderful daughter.
Bye. We see it all with wonder.
We dream it every. Yeah, the end's incredibly hard worker. She was flying over the furniture.
Flipping over the couch as a walk table.
When we were at the park, she'd always be tumbling.
Jade was about four. We were watching TV one evening, and she runs by and does a cartwheel. And I looked at him, and I was like, did you teach her that? And he said, no, did you? And I said, no, we're in trouble.
I like the gymnastics.
She has something. Coaches see it. You're going to be an Olympian, so let's roll with it.
I mean, we have an incredible bond.
Dad, Brian, a coach.
To be on this journey with her, it's just been incredible.
No words. I can't describe everything that is going through my head. It's the biggest joy in the world.
This is where our dreams begin.
Yeah.
It was the greatest routine Suni Lee has ever done.
Oh my God.
It's supported everything that I've ever wanted to do.
And I'm proud of Simone.
She's our superhero because she kind of just, she takes things and she makes them good.
This is where our dreams begin.
Thank you. You guys got material though.
Did I just get emotional?
Yeah, we got to do this right now. I'd have to cut that one.
It is not just the athletes living the journey, dreaming, but the parents, no doubt, thoughts of those early days when all things were just starting on the road to this night and eventually perhaps the Olympics. Don't know that the athletes have reflected on that tonight. They're busy competing, but the parents certainly have. So the selection committee has gone to the back room to figure things out. The athletes leaving right now, and so it is that time where everybody just sits in the house here and waits. And you two are Olympians. You know what this is like. Take me to this moment, the next 15 or 20 minutes.
Oh, man, you are just breathing really fast or maybe forgetting to breathe, and you just know your dreams and your fate are in the hands of three people.
It's nerve-wracking, but there's a sense of relief that the process is over and you have to sit and wait. I know in 2000 I was at the mercy of a selection committee. They marched us, the whole group of us, onto the floor. The guys that made it and didn't make it. And they announced us one at a time, and you stood there next to guys who didn't make it, and you just waited to hear your name. And talk about excruciating. It's an emotional moment, to say the very least.
So what do you think? We started the night by saying you had the four athletes who were in Tokyo at the Olympics, and perhaps, this is just a thought, we don't know this because it's not just the math like it was for the men's team yesterday, but maybe that one spot. Your thoughts now, having watched the action tonight?
Yeah, there was a few things during the competition that made me second guess my original thought, which was the four athletes that competed in Tokyo, and Hesley Rivera really knocked it out of the park and earned her spot, in my opinion, on this team.
I agree. I think it's going to be really hard to justify not putting her on that team. I will give a shout out to Jocelyn Robertson. I have never seen her look better, and she was her best at the right time, but I just don't know if it's good enough. Hesley was amazing.
So Simone Biles has wrapped up a spot, winning the all-around here, but the other four spots, it is subjective. Comes down to the selection committee. We'll see.
Last 2 weeks, whether it was diving or swimming or track and field or the trials here in gymnastics, it has been full of excitement as we are now 3.5 weeks from competition beginning for the Paris Games. So as the action has ended out here, this is where the focus was. Everybody's still in their seats because of what's about to come. Come with me. The action has come back this direction because now it's in the hands of the selection committee. So unlike the men's selection, which we had yesterday afternoon for you on NBC, that was more of a math problem, and that was decided. Here, other than Simone Biles, the question is, who's going to make the team, the other four? And that means there's a little bit of discretion involved. So we're going to take you back here behind these doors, because back in this area is where the three people in the selection committee are meeting. They're back here, and they're deciding who the other four are going to be to join Simone Biles on the U.S. Olympic women's gymnastics team. For the parents, those four parents, there's a lot of pressure of this moment right now, because the waiting is the hardest part. They're about to find out if their daughters will be part of Team USA. The waiting continues. There'll be confetti. There'll be celebration. There'll be tears for a variety of reasons in a little bit.
Continue to wait on the naming of the women's team who'll be competing in Paris. Yesterday, the men competed. It was day two for them, and the team was named. Yeah, they were. Tears and cheers and smiles all around. Mom Judah, Asher Hong right there. So you got Brody Malone certainly leading the way, along with Frederick Richard, Steven Edorozic, pommel horse specialist, and those are the names who'll be competing in Paris, and the alternate Shane Wiskus and Coy Young, joined by Tim Daggett now. And Tim and I were here to call the action yesterday. It did come down to the wire. Different selection process based on math. That's the team. Your thoughts on the makeup of the team?
Well, it's been, you know, 16 years since the U.S. has won an Olympic team medal. But in 2023, they were able to get a bronze at the World Championships. Three of those team members made the Olympics. Asher Hong, Fred Richard, and Paul Judah. The other two athletes are individual world champions, Steven Nedorozic on pommel horse and Brody Malone on high bar. So they got the firepower to go to Paris and win a medal.
Yeah, that world bronze medal, first time in a while there. How about individual in terms of medals there then?
Oh, there's a lot of potential. Fred Richard, I mean, he just was phenomenal at his first world championships, won a bronze medal. First time ever going out on that floor. And Brody Malone, he is back He didn't have the best meet here, but don't count him out at all.
He was sensational coming back from injury at the U.S. Championships about a month ago. He'll be one of the leaders, Frederick Richard as well. Lili Leung, president and CEO of USA Gymnastics, out here with the crowd, waiting with everybody else as the music plays. They got some entertainment out there, but we wait on the selection committee. And as we do, we send it over to Zora.
Thank you, Terry. We have a lot of Olympians up here. We've got Avita from Rhythmic Gymnastics. We've got Alexi and Jessica from Trampoline. You all know these guys, the men's artistic gymnasts. So somehow Paul Judah got tabbed as the spokesperson for this men's team. A lot of emotions in the last 24 hours, so we need to do a check-in, Paul. Where's the head at?
Yeah, I don't think any more tears today. But it's sinking in. We've got such a strong group here, and we're really excited to head to Paris.
Thank you, Paul. Avita Griskenis is right next to me. You are the only rhythmic gymnast going to Paris on behalf of Team USA. What does it mean to have the United States of America across your chest once again?
It means a big thank you, actually, because even though I'm the only person competing on the stage, there is all of Team USA behind me, every single person in the audience, my coaches, staff, like literally anyone you can think of, even the person in the grocery store who says I'm cheering you on, they're all with me there on the carpet.
She's feeling a lot of gratitude right now. Thank you so much. Let's bring in Alexi and Jessica. If you all just want to scoot down a little bit. So you got Alexi Shostak and Jessica Stevens, trampoline contingency here. Okay, so the United States has never won a medal in trampoline. What do you think of the opportunity ahead?
I think it's a fabulous opportunity for us. I would like to, you know, get a medal for Team USA and
You got it.
USA Trampoline. I think it would be a huge honor to bring it home.
Let's give it up for all these Olympians. Terry, take it away.
Zora, thank you. So congratulations and good luck. And good luck to the parents, too, who are still waiting. Not much going on. Just the waiting. Longest, hardest part of the evening for them.
A shout out to the fans of the Twin Cities, Minneapolis and St. Paul, from either side of the river, all coming here to downtown Minnesota, Minneapolis, for a wonderful weekend. Up next, the announcement of the five women heading to Paris, the latest defining moment in a long legacy of making Team USA.
The selection committee is meeting and talking right now, coming up with the names to complete Team USA.
Sitting in that room is just so emotional and it's just so nerve-wracking. You know, everyone's worked so hard, and you just really don't know.
Athletes train their whole lives for the chance to compete in the Olympic Games. It is a dream, the hope of many, but the reality of few.
All my life, I've been dreaming about this every night before I go to bed.
I've wanted it since I was a kid.
It's such an honor to be able to go to the Olympic Games, so we all want it so bad.
We are told they have made the selection.
It is time now to meet the members of Team USA.
This is the best moment in my whole entire life. I'm so happy right now.
Oh my God, my dreams are finally coming true and I'm going to the Olympics.
I'm proud to be representing USA and I'm gonna give it all I got.
I still can't even believe it. It's just a very emotional night.
Now we have an Olympian as a son. That's crazy.
I had only one goal, and it was to hit all my routines and leave here healthy. So I'm happy to do that and more. Go Team USA!
We are only 26 days away from the opening ceremony of the 2024 Paris Olympic Games. Athletes train their whole lives for the chance to compete in the Olympic Games. It's a dream, a hard-fought fight, the hope of many, but the reality of few. For these athletes, the road to Paris starts now. Here to present for the first time
your Women's Artistic Gymnastics Olympic team for Paris 2024, please welcome two legendary members of Team USA. 2004 Team USA Olympic all-around gold medal champion and USA Gymnastics Hall of Famer, Carly Patterson. And two-time world all-around gold medal champion and two-time Olympian with seven Olympic medals, USA Gymnastics Hall of Famer, Shannon Miller.
Please welcome the five members of the 2024 Women's Artistic Gymnastics Olympic Team. Jordan Childs.
Team USA Women's Olympic Team, one for all. Welcome back, the men of Team USA for Artistic Gymnastics. Your Team USA for Rhythmic Gymnastics. And your Team USA for Trampoline Gymnastics. Your 2024 USA Olympic Team!
So there you have it. The team has been named. These are the athletes who will represent the U.S. in Paris at the Olympics. Four athletes who competed in Tokyo the last time around. Simone Biles, Suni Lee, Jordan Chiles, and Jade Carey. Just the second time and the first time since 1952 that the U.S. is sending four women back to the Olympics who are already Olympians. And then that fifth spot, what was in question all night and throughout the trials, it goes to a 16-year-old from New Jersey, Hesley Rivera, who is just a year removed from competing on the junior level. Amazing.
She's so young, but tonight she competed like a veteran, a seasoned athlete. It's going to make for a great Team USA, Terry.
And I'm not sure you can even capture the words to describe how that man feels right now. He has been something else. He's been as entertaining as Rivera's dad and mom to watch in the stands as the athletes tonight.
I mean, the support that is radiating through him and all the parents.
So the celebration continues, and we send it over to Zora.
Thank you, Terry. I am with the five women that will be heading to Paris who have earned a spot on Team USA. We have to start with the hometown hero, Suni Lee. Suni, only you know what you've been through in the past few years. How have you persevered and earned another chance to represent this country?
Well, I was just reminded of my goals every day and constantly surrounded by people who never let me give up. And I'm so thankful because a year ago, I didn't even think this was... I didn't think this was possible, so I'm so grateful, and all of these amazing ladies are absolutely incredible, so I can't wait to be in Paris!
Jade, let's go to you now. You've been through an Olympic cycle before. How do you think your experiences in the past helped you get through this trials, get through the past 3 years, and stand on this stage?
This is the most stressful meet I've ever been a part of in my life. But just those past experiences, like you said, really helped me, reminded me of why I'm doing this sport and where I want to go. And I couldn't do it without my family, my coaches, my friends, even these ladies right here. So I'm ready to rock it in Paris with them.
Jordan. I don't think anyone can work a crowd like Jordan Chiles, okay? Jordan, you've been so open with us about the year that you've had, the loss, and can you talk about how you've persevered, how you have overcome? Because I know you've been through a lot.
Honestly, one thing I can say, it's all God. I wouldn't be where I am right now if it wasn't for him, if it wasn't for these amazing ladies, my coaches, my family, my friends. I was out here today doing it for the two I lost last year, my grandpa and my aunt. They always believed in me, and that's what made me continue to push my dream, push to another in Olympics, which is crazy to say. And this one's for you, Uncle and Megan. I'm going to the Olympics.
Let's keep the smiles going, because I hate to see all these tears. Jordan, the way that you bring your whole self to gymnastics, what role does that play in helping you succeed out here?
I honestly think it's with this one right here. She has honestly put me...
She has honestly put me in a position to understand what it's like to be an athlete in your sport and also a person as well. So being able to mature in my sport, mature in life, mature in just everything that I've been doing, I give thanks to this one right here because I wouldn't be in this position right now.
Okay, the baby of the group, come on over, Hesley. 16 years old! How'd you do it, Hesley?
God. My coaches, my family, my friends, my teammates, they're all so supportive of me, and I'm so grateful for everything. You know, I've made a lot of sacrifices to be here, so I'm just so incredibly grateful forever. I cannot be more happy. I'm ecstatic.
Simone, like, do you feel a sense of responsibility to take care of these women? They put so much on you, my goodness.
Yes, I mean, I am kind of, I used to call Allie grandma, and I've surpassed that. So I love you, Allie, but I love these girls, so I'm going to take care of them in Paris.
All right. You're gymnast for Paris. Congrats, ladies. Terry.
Well, Zora, thank you. It wraps up an exciting Olympic trials all the way across the board as the gymnastics team is set. Now the countdown really begins. 26 days. Until July 26th, that opening ceremony is they'll be part of the Team USA flotilla, if you will, coming down the Seine River. As we wrap up this day, maybe a five-minute stretch shows you everything. Simone Biles, that amazing first pass, up to 12 feet in the air. Her comeback trail unique. So too was Suni Lee, coming back from dealing with two separate kidney ailments, nailing her final routine. And the two of them, together with the joy and the celebration, the reality of they've made it through a lot to make it back to the Olympic Games. So that's part of the story. But the rest of the story is, can this team bring home a gold medal? They did not in the last Olympics in the team competition. The men hope to bring home a medal for the first time since 2008. For the women and Simone Biles, it will not be a coronation, but the competition really has raised to another level with their performances here this weekend in Minneapolis. A reminder, your late local news is coming up next. Hoda Kotb talks to Team USA's gymnast tomorrow morning on the Today Show. For our entire team here in Minnesota, Mike Tirico saying so long from the U.S. Olympic Trials and Making Team USA, presented by Xfinity. The joy of making Team USA for these gymnasts on the road to Paris. And we will see you for the opening ceremony in 26 days.